Hey guys, what's up? It's Kay, and today we are, here's my wife. Say hi, wife.
Hi,
hi, wife. And we're here in San Japan, and it's my first time dressing up, and it's weird. It's very weird. And I'm cosplaying as a Japanese guy. And I'm cosplaying as a Japanese guy that's in a convention. So I think I got it. I think I nailed it. So yeah, it's just weird. It's just weird, like, going to a convention all dressed up, because I normally go with just my casual clothes. And now we're just trying to find that booth where we're gonna buy the tickets.
Thank you.
ba yung nakikita ko? Nang nasa likod ko? Tama ba yung nasa likod ko na ganyan ang ginagawa nila?
So I'm kind of done for the day, and me and my wife just went to San Japan. It's pretty much the only anime convention that's happening in San Antonio every year, and I was pretty sure that we weren't going, but the wife wanted to go, so we dressed up for the first time. So I'm wearing this yukata. And it was it was okay, but I think growing up in the Philippines, the anime conventions that I went to was, for me, it's better. But one thing I liked about conventions in America, or I guess here in San Antonio, was the venues are pretty big. It can accommodate. It can actually accommodate the visitors that's gonna go to the venue. Unlike in the Philippines, the venue is big, but it's not big enough to accommodate the visitors or the convention goers. So sometimes it comes to a point where you have just, you know, that little small walking space, or your personal space is just gone. Especially when you go to the Philippines' biggest toy convention that happens every year. That one's worse. Like, you'll have no walking space, or your personal space is pretty much gone because of the people that go there. For the merchandise, pretty much, since, you know, I'm looking for imported figures, most of the ones I saw was overpriced, so I wasn't really interested in buying some of those. But the only thing that I got was that was pretty similar to the ones I see online is this one. So I got the Robot Tamashii XX. I can't wait to work on this one next. Well, after Ultraman or something. But I'll be working on this soon. And I got a sweet. Let's see, let me open this. I'll be using this in a bit. Got a sweet, you can see it's a Totoro shirt. Because who doesn't love Totoro? He's cute. So I'll be wearing this in a bit. Give me a few seconds. I can't wait to wear this. Alright, so yep, this was the Totoro shirt that I got. It's pretty awesome. I love this shirt. I love it. So going back, a very good friend of mine on Facebook is gonna sell me his spare SHF X Ultra Act figure, the manga version of Ultraman, and we plan on detailing up the figure with panel lines, a little bit of weathering, and some added paint chip effect on that one. Hopefully it turns out really well. My tools are actually ready. I bought some paints, I bought some Tamiya weathering tools. So I'm pretty excited for that, and that's pretty much it. I just wanted to show my friends how anime conventions are like here in San Antonio, Texas. I like how you have that personal space, and the venue is pretty big, and you don't have to worry about your walking space pretty much. And next month we'll be going to the Alamo City Comic Con, which will happen on the same venue, which is that one. It's a big convention area, so we'll be meeting a few celebrities. I wanted to meet Ric Flair. I'm a huge Ric Flair fan, and I wanted to meet Alanna Masterson from The Walking Dead, but she got canceled because she got pregnant, and she's my celebrity crush, so that kind of sucked. But I wanted to go there to meet Ric Flair as well, and hopefully some good merchandise. I'm looking for the Robot Damashi Hyakushiki. Hopefully I see it next month in the shelf. But yeah, so I hope you guys enjoyed the video. So watch out for my next one. It's pretty much gonna be the Ultraman figure that I'll be uploading sometime in September. So thank you guys for watching.